additive inverse of the, if you reverse the fraction, take the additive inverse of this, what it becomes? It becomes minus x minus. Why? Because we are changing the numerator and denominator, as numerator as denominator, denominator as numerator. In that case, you can change the power as minus. So that means why? Because we are using this formula, a power minus m is equal to 1 by a power m. So if you bring it automatically to the up, automatically minus. That's why means if the denominator become numerator, the value becomes minus. In the same principle we are using here, by changing, interchanging the numerator and denominator, automatically the power can be multiplied by minus. Now we can see here, simplify it first. A by b whole power x minus 1 is equal to a by b, as usual, minus into x, minus into minus plus 3. Now you see, our intention is that you have to make the bases are same. If the bases are equal, we already well familiar. If bases are equal, then the exponents are same. Then the exponents are also equal. By using this principle, what are the exponents here? Here the exponent is minus 1 is equal to, what is the one another exponent? Minus x plus 3. Bring all the variables one side, all the constants on other side. Bring minus 1 this side, automatically already left hand side plus x is there. If you bring minus this side, what it becomes? Plus x. Here already right hand side 3 is there. Bring minus 1 this side, what it becomes? Plus 1. So what is the answer for this? X plus x is 2x. Okay, 3 plus 1 is equal to 4. Therefore x is equal to 4 divided by 2. Why? Because 2 is multiplying here. If you bring this side, what it becomes? Divided. So x is equal to 2, 1 is 2, 2, 2. So you can do the problems like this. Our intention is, in such a problems, our intention is that you have to make the you have to make the bases are equal. Even if not there, if they are not equal, make it equal and change the necessary things. Are you got it? Okay, ma? You can get it. Now you can go for one more, one another okay problem we will see. X power a divided by x power b whole power c into x power b divided by x power c whole power a into x power c divided by x power a whole power b. Find the value of x by x power a by x power b whole power c, x by b whole by x power c whole power a, x by x power c divided by x power a whole power b. How can you do the answer for this? As usual, you know that we are using one principle here, a power m whole power n is equal to a power m into n. Apply the principle here. What it becomes? A power a into c, x power a c divided by, apply the same principle in the denominator also, x power b into c, what it becomes? B c into, apply the same rule here also, x power b into a, instead of b into a, in an order I am writing, a into b is equal to b into a, we know 2 into 3 anna okate, 3 into 2 anna okate kada. I am writing a first question without alphabets law. X power c whole power a is nothing but x power a into c. C into a into c, both are same. Into x power c into b is what? Bc divided by x power a into b, it is already in order. Now you see here, all are in multiplication, all the fractions are in multiplication. Go for simplify all the things. X power AB, X power AB, both are get cancelled. X power AC, X power AC. X power BC, X power BC. So one by one, all the things are what? One. So what is the answer for this? One. So can anybody say that what is the other method to solve this? See here, I can do in one another way. Instead of this, we know this, if you apply this formula for this, a power m divided by a power n is equal to, we know that a power m minus n. Apply the formula here, in that case also you can get the answer. So what is this? A power m divided by a power n is equal to a power m minus n whole power c into, go for this. What it becomes again? A power m divided by a power n, a power m minus n whole power into, so as usual, x power c minus a whole power. Don't think that here, sir, you say no, sir, both are same. C minus a is not equal to a minus c. Remember this. This is not equal. When the numbers are in multiplication, the order wherever it is okay. But in the case of subtraction, it is not applicable. Now you can go for multiply. You apply the same rule here. A power m whole power n is equal to a power m into n. Go for this. X power a minus b into c. Multiply with all the terms with this. A into c, ac minus b into c, bc into x power, as usual, both b into a, ab minus c into a, ac. Multiplication lo a order lo na raichu, subtraction lo raidandi. X power c into b, bc minus a into b, a. Now you are applying one more formula here. A power m, a power n into a power one another q. So if you, all the bases are equal when they are in multiplication, write it as a one base and add all the exponents. AC minus BC plus AB minus AC plus BC minus AB. But remember this, all the sequence must be in the power only. So many of you I observed, some students are getting down all these things. They are bringing them to the denominator. Don't think, see here, only all the terms are under the base of x. Now we cancel it. Plus ac minus a, plus bc minus bc, ab minus x power 0. Anything power 0 is always 1. Are you got it? So however you can do the answer, however the principle you are going to use, you can get the same answer at last. I think so. All of you clear? Now we'll go for one another type of a problem. Find the value of x power b whole power a plus b into x power b divided by x power c whole power b plus c into x power c divided by x power a whole power c plus c. See here, same thing, we are extending our this thing, we are increasing the difficulty level, that's all. See here, how to do the answer for this? As usual, you can apply any one rule, whatever the rule we explain the two principles here, the same thing you are going to apply here, you can get the answer. See here, one thing, for such problems without doing the calculation, how you are going to keep the answer? Anyhow, the answer is 1. How can you say that the answer is 1 by seeing it? Automatically you can see here, x power a, x power b, a, b, b, c, c, a. they are in, this is called cyclic rotation, we can say. Eppude gaane ee powers gaane ledha evana numbers cyclic rotation lo vaste, then automatically all the powers can be get cancelled and you can get one as the answer. Remember this. But remember that how you are going to keep the answer, you should check whether all the numbers are in cyclic rotation or cyclic form. See here also, AB, A plus B, again continuation, B plus C, again continuation, C plus A, again from C to A, again it is repeated. AB, BC, CA, again BC, CA, like that you are going to continue. If the process is like this, in the continuation state, that is called cyclic form or cyclic notation, then the answer is always 1, remember. Otherwise, you can go for it. X power A into A plus B. Again, here also if you go for like this, if you calculate and expand it, automatically you can get cancelled. All the things are get cancelled and at last you can get 1 as answer. So this is the one way to get the answer. When do you get 1? You can get the 1 when they are in cyclic form. Means they are in order. Means suppose you are, you see here, ABC is the order. First you are taking AB, next BC, next CA. In the same way you are continuing, means this is called cyclic rotation. CA means after that AB, BC, CA. Again, AB, BC, CA. This form is called as cyclic form. If these things are in cyclic form, then you can go that the answer, all the things are get cancelled and at last you are going to get 1. If you check previous one also, it is in a cyclic form. That's why you are going to get the 1 as answer. If anyone have to solve it, you solve it. If not, you just scroll me on the, you message me on the scroll board. Tomorrow we will do it otherwise. Okay? Now, go for one more. Okay. Find the value of M where 47 point power 6.5 into 47 power 5.9 into 47 power 3.7 into 47 power 11.3 is equal to 47.2 m. 47 power 2 m. If this is the case, so find the value of m. You want to find the value of m here. You want to find the value of m. You know that all, you observe the bases now. All the bases are equal and they are in the multiplication. That's why you can, you are going to use the principle as a power m into a power n is equal to a power m plus n. Whatever it may be, a power m into a power n, a power p into a power q, if you go on like this, you get the answer as a power m plus n plus p plus q. Okay, like that. Better on the left hand side you observe that. So what so many people, you people are doing is nothing but by seeing the question itself, what is this? This is in confusion state. Like that you can think. But if you observe carefully, automatically it will become very easy. All are having the basis, same basis. That's why you can keep it as only one base and add all the exponents. That is nothing but 6.5 is equal to 47 power 2m. Are you get it? Okay. Now, if you see like this, automatically all the bases are equal. So they are in the multiplication. You should add up all the exponents having a one base. Now you can go for adding it. 6.5, 5.9, 3.7, 11.3. 7 plus 3, 10, 19 plus 5, 24. 8 plus 5, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. So what is the answer? 47 whole power 27.4. That is equal to 47 whole power 2. Now you see, in both the cases, all the bases are equal. So exponents are also equal. We know this formula, not necessary to write. So now we can go for 2m is equal to 27.4. What is m now? M is equal to 27.4 divided by 2. Simplify it now with 2. If you divide it, 2 1 is 2, 2 3 are 6. Point is there, 2 7 are. So what is the answer here? 13.7. So what is the value of m? So m is equal to 13.7. So like this, we are going.